Let's look at the solution to our disk access time quiz. We can ignore queuing, so our read of a randomly chosen byte begins by seeking there. The head assembly is at one end of the disk. A randomly chosen byte will be at the cylinder where we are, or 999 cylinders away, or anywhere in between with equal probability. So on average, we will be seeking 500 cylinders away times 10 microseconds per cylinder. So our seek will take us 5 milliseconds. At that point, our head is in a random place on the correct track. Now we need to wait for the beginning of the correct sector to get under the head. And just like when we were doing the seek, the rotational latency will be on average half of a rotation. Sometimes we will be lucky and land just at the very beginning of the sector we want. Sometimes we will be unlucky and land just past the beginning of the sector we want. So we will not be able to read that sector, even though we are technically right above the data we want to read. We will have to wait for the beginning of the sector to get back, which is a whole rotation. So on average, we will be having half a rotation. Each rotation is a hundredth of a second, or 10 milliseconds. So we end up adding another 5 milliseconds to our read time. Next, we need to read our sector. There are 10 sectors per track, so the read will take 1/10 of a rotation, which will be 1 millisecond, because we already determined that a rotation will be 10 milliseconds. So in total, it will take 11 milliseconds to complete our disk access.